Hello students, I am Rajesh Tiyar. I am from Mechanical Department, Gopalan College of Engineering and Management. I am working as an assistant professor in this college. Today, the topic is shortest job first scheduling. What does this topic represents? What does this topic tells us? Here the topic is yes, Tiyar. Now I am going to explain you what does it mean. It is a non-preemptive. Once CPU given to the process, it cannot be preempted until it completes the CPU burst. Ready queue is treated as a priority queue based on smallest CPU time requirement. Under this, the topics are like priorities are assigned in inverse order of time needed for the completion of the entire job. If equal time of completion, then FCFS is used for assigning priorities. Arriving jobs inserted at proper position in queue gives minimum average waiting time for a given set of process, minimizes average turnaround time. A job exceeding the resources estimation is aborted. Exponential averaging is used to estimate the process burst duration. Examples, here are some examples for this. In this, process as taken as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Burst time is 6, 8, 7, 3. Arrival is taken as 0 for everything. Start time is taken as 3, 16, 9, 0. Wait is 3, 16, 9, 0. Finish is 9, 24, 16, 3. TA is taken as 9, 24, 16, 3. It is a chart called Gantt chart. In this chart, you will get to know what is P4, P1, P3, P2. P4 lies from 0 to 3, P1 lies from 3 to 9, and P3 lies from 9 to 16. And T2 lies from 16 to 24. Regenerated from OSC8 P.190. Regenerated from OSCJ8 P200. Average waiting time is taken as 3 plus 16 plus 9 plus 0. It is nothing but the wait time divided by 4 is equal to 7. Average turnaround time. It is 9 plus 24 plus 16 plus 3. It is nothing but the finish time divided by 4 is equal to 13. Now, so here is some advantages for this. Some of the advantages are short process are executed first and then followed by longer process. The throughput is increased because more processes can be executed in less amount of time. These are the some advantages for that. Here is some disadvantages for this. Some of them are the time taken by a process must be known by the CPU beforehand, which is not possible. Longer processes will have more waiting time. Eventually, they will suffer starvation. These are the information which has been collected from the various links and the web pages. Some of the links are greek4greeks.org and the wikipedia.org, ekpedia.com, sciencehq.com. These are the links from this links only that this resources has been collected.